Hey guys, so welcome to the first video of console tutorial. So I will make a series of tutorials using console multiphysics in which you are going to see the stress analysis, thermal analysis, electrical analysis and many more. So this is the first video in which I'm going to show you that how can you do stress analysis of thin plate under stationary loads. So we are going to do the stress analysis of a thin plate having stationary loads. So this is the word file, or you can say the report, which you can get after doing analysis, and this is the result for that. So how to get this report, how to do stress analysis, let's see in the console. So if you open a console, you can see this window. Now click on this model wizard. Over here, as we are doing the 2D analysis, you have to click this 2D dimension space. So 2D space dimension, now what we are doing the stress analysis. So from this physics, from all this given physics, we have to select the structure. And then we have to click on the plate, because we are doing the analysis of a 2D plate. So click on this plate and then click on add button. So physics has been added to the current model. And now as you can see, you have the review of that physics, like you have the displacement field given by you, then you have field components and displacement of cell normals, which are given by all these parameters or variables. Now you have to click this study. Now we are studying the stationary, so we have to select stationary, which is like the analysis or the values or the anything related to the study will not change with respect to time. So over here it is not change with respect to the time. Okay, so we have added the study and now click on done. So after clicking that, you can see you will get this kind of window in console. Okay, so now what you need to do, first thing is that you need to select the units. So we are in the geometry section and we need to change the units. So we are using SI units and let's use meter for that. Angular unit is degrees. So this has been done. Just click on build all. Now we need to draw the geometry for this. So for that, we will go for the geometry tab on the upper menus. So go to the geometry tab. Over here we need to build a rectangle, so click on a rectangle. And now we have to give the parameters or the values for that. So it is solid. You can label that rectangle as a plate. Then give the width. So let's say width is 5, height is 10, and the position of the center, position of the origin is at center. It is not, so we are not rotating the plate, and that's all for this. Click on build, selected. So now as you can see, it is like enlarged. You have to zoom it out or like zoom extend, that can make the plate like this. So now as you can see, we got the plate for our analysis and it is 2D. So now you can't rotate this thing, it is 2D. Okay, so click on this to zoom out, like to make the plate within this frame. And this is like zoom to selection. What happens if you click on this, you have to select that and you can zoom for that. And this is like for zooming more by clicking on this zoom box. Okay, so we have created a plate having width of 5 and height of 10. So now what we need to do, we need to create some holes along this plate for stress analysis, because we are going to do stress analysis in a plate containing some deformity, some holes or some flaws, some cracks for that. Okay, so now how to create a circular hole? For that, what we need to do, we need to create a circle. So we are in the geometry tab, click on this circle, and we will draw the circle over here. So now let's see. Okay, so center is 0, 0, radius is, let's give it like 0.5, and click on build selected. So we got a circle over here. Let's create some more circles. So I will just duplicate this circle, 1 and 2. So we got one. The second one, we need to just change the position. So now the radius, let's make it same for the center. So this is x-axis, this is y-axis. So let's give y equal to 5 and let's click on build selected. So as you can see, it reaches on the top of that top edge. For the circle 3, give it minus 5 and click on build selected. So as you can see, we got the next circle at the bottom edge. So now we need to remove these parts from this rectangular box. Okay, so now we want to subtract these circles from the rectangle. For that, we will go to the boolean operation, go for difference and object to add, click on the rectangle, then object to subtract, make it like active, then click this circle. Okay, it has selected the whole rectangle. Click on the bottom circle. Okay, let's move this. Now click on this circle, the top one and the bottom one. Click on build selected, and we got a rectangular plate having holes, having flaws, having cracks. Then click on form union. That's fine, because like there is no other geometries. That's fine if it but maybe we are just making it build all. Okay, so now we got a plate and with some circular holes. Now the next step is that we need to give the materials for this plate. So click on the material, and we can go over here, we can browse material, or we can select from this. But let's go add material, and then from the inbuilt material we can provide the material to our sample. So let's see built-in material what we have. Okay, so let's click on the stainless steel, and just click on this, click on add to component. Okay, so now material has been assigned to this plate. Okay, that's good. We can see what we have. We have density, we have Young modulus which is needed, and we have the Poisson ratio for this steel. Okay, so now the next thing is that after assigning the material, we need to apply the load, and we need to mesh this geometry. Okay, so now we will apply the boundary condition. We apply the loads for this plate. So for that, we will go to the physics, and over here we will choose some fixed, like we are stretching this along this line, and this will remain as a, let's say, fixed. So as you can see over here, boundaries, go to the boundaries and go to the fixed constraint and select the edges which you want to fix. Okay, so we fixed that boundaries. Now we want to apply the loads, like we want to apply the load to this plate. For that, so go for boundaries and go for edge load and select this edge, both edges, and we want to apply that load in x direction. So let's give the force as 150 newton meter. So moment, we are not applying any moment, just the load, and that's all. Okay, so the now the edge load has been applied to this geometry, and this is like zoom to selection, and this is for clear selection. Okay, so we have applied the load. Now we will mesh this. Click on the mesh, and you can use physics control mesh. You can select the size for the elements. Let's make it just fine. Click on build all. You can see the mesh has been generated. Now just solve this. So for that, go to home, compute, and that can compute the stresses, all the values for you. Okay, so now as you can see, we got the results. So what we have, it is like the stress. Okay, so this is a stress, as you can see over here. So we got the stresses for this now. Okay, so what I'm doing, I just click on this stress top, and then I just click the second surface. Or what I can do, I can just delete this because it is like overcoming, like it is making, like it is combining both the result. Let's delete this. Go to the result, click on 2D plot so that I can get this next a second plot for that. So 2D plot. So as you can see over here, it's a 2D plot. After 2D plot, click on this and click on surface. So now over here we want a displacement. Click on the plot. So now this will give me displacement, this will give me the stresses. Okay, so as you can see, this is total displacement which we got, and this is the stresses over here. This is the expression which I can change. Let's say so you can't change the expression because that means you are changing this thing. Okay, so let's for that, for you need to go to title, click on the manual, and over right here on my says stress, and then click on the plot. So we will got a title over here. So this is the, in this way you can generate the stresses. In this way you can generate the total displacement. So this is the expression for that. You can change the expression, like you can also define your bar, like from this. So plate, if you want displacement, energy, power, you can choose. If you want strain, click on the principal strain in one direction, and then click on this, click on plot. So that can give you the principal strain in x direction. Strain is having no units. Okay, so in this way you can select different plots, different entities, different parameters to get the stress and strain. Okay, so now how to get the report after doing all the simulation. Okay, so now if you want to generate the report for this, you have to click on this report, right click on that, click on the brief report. If you want intermediate report, you can click on this one. If you want complete report, you can click on this one. So we are just want brief report, click on this, write the report name, template is like brief, format like output is Word, file name, we can select the folder which you want to save it, and give the file name. I want to save it like in this console, models console, click on save. As you can see over here, it's like default template. Then images is like medium, type of images like JPEG. Okay, so we have done this. Now you need to click on the preview selected, that will generate the report. So this is the report I have generated. So this is the report we got. Click on the write, that will write the report, and you can get the report over here. So in this way you can generate the report, a Word format, whatever you've done for the analysis. Okay, so that's the first video for this COMSOL simulation of stress analysis of a plate. Thank you for watching it.